So now I've got the Honda CX500 engine out of the motorcycle, and in this episode we're going to tear open the backside of this engine and get into that stator, which needs to be replaced, and we'll also look at the water pump while we're in there. Welcome to Urban Monk TV. Okay, welcome back everybody. So let's get the back of this engine apart and see what we find inside with our stator and our water pump. I've ordered up some parts, but I imagine I'll probably need to order up some additional parts before I can put it all back together. But wanted to give a quick shout out to a viewer named Dave. I will refrain from using your last name because I don't have your permission to do so, but Dave hired me recently to consult via webcam on a project he had with his Suzuki V-Strom, which of course I own one and do a lot of videos on maintenance on that bike also. He was putting on some auxiliary lights, as many adventure riders do, and I have a video series on how to wire up the circuit for that with a relay. And anyways, he hired me to consult. We got the lights working and it was a really pleasant experience. So just a shout out to Dave. Thank you very much. I appreciate the opportunity to help you with that. And if anyone else is interested in having me consult on a particular project, I am open to discussing projects like that. Reach out to me through the contact form on urbanmonktv.com, or you can email me at urbanmonktv@gmail.com, and I'll get it either way through the same email account. So what do I got here? I know I've got a bad stator. For those that are joining, you know, I guess at this video and not following the whole series, and the stator is in the back of the engine here. And the water pump is also here. I bought a couple of parts I want to show you in anticipation of doing this job. So it was apparent to me right out of the gate that if I'm going to take this rear cover off, that I'm going to end up having to replace this seal. You know, not that I have to, but kind of good practice. But I noticed, I just ordered up a seal, you know, not the Honda seal, but just a good seal that has the same dimensions. But I noticed that, I think, we'll see when we get this apart, that this whole flange is actually incorporated into this seal on the final shaft. And of course that lip holds the rubber boot that shrouds the this whole connection. And so I don't know how I'm gonna hold that rubber boot if I have a different kind of seal without the flange. So we'll see later. You know, stay tuned to an upcoming episode when we put this all back together to see how I solve that problem. This seal is like $90 from you know, a Honda parts supplier, if you get the actual Honda part. But you know, other than that, it's just an oil seal. So we'll see. And then I ordered up a seal for the gear shift shaft. And inside the water pump is a mechanical seal, which is a little, let me take this out. So again, this is for the water pump shaft, and it's just a rubber seal with a spring on it, and it's a two-piece design. This one is, again, not genuine Honda. I got a much better price on one that's not Honda branded, but you know, construction seems good. We'll see when we get it apart. And then I just got a water pump seal for this water pump cover, which we're going to need to get into. The other thing that I have not received yet, but I ordered up a couple of them, and now I'm thinking, you know, I should have ordered more than two because they use quite a few of these. There are some O-rings here and then in here and in here.
Let me get the dimensions on those O-rings in millimeters and I'll put them up on the screen here. But they are, there's more than one of them in the bike, and I only ordered two for up here, but then I realized, well, actually there's probably one in there also. So get a bunch of those ahead of time.
Since we are getting into the water pump, we are going to have to drain the cooling systems. The drain for the cooling system is under a plastic plate here, so I'm going to have to get these screws out.
There is our drain screw, and it is a 14 millimeter.
So in most cases, you would be draining this while it's on the bike, and you can do it either way, it's not a big deal, but that drain plug is back far enough to where they kind of assume that you'll get a drain pan under the engine, because again, this is all hanging in the motorcycle at that time. My clearances are a little tighter, so I'm just putting in a funnel to catch it and bring it in here. You don't need a very large container. There's just under 2 US quarts of coolant in here. But first thing you want to do is loosen your radiator cap up top, because otherwise it's not going to drain. It's like having your finger on the top of a straw, right? Hey, there you go. With the cooling system now drained, I can start taking some of these cooling system components off, like this tube. And this is a 4 millimeter hex, or an Allen wrench. This clamp in particular is going to need some TLC. I'm going to get some penetrating oil on that first before I attempt to take that off. That's in rough shape. I'm going to attempt to hold the, you know, the main part of the clamp, because it's just twisting like this as I turn it. There we go. Okay. You know, believe it or not, that isn't in as bad a shape as one might think. I may be able to clean that up and reuse it. Okay. There's one of those O-rings that I need at least three now. We'll see. I got liquid in there. I'm gonna get a pan. Go. Worked. So I think it's worth noting here that as I restore this motorcycle from here on out, there's going to be a lot of cleaning of individual parts, like this hose clamp. Here's this hose clamp before, and here's this hose clamp after I cleaned it up. So I'm not going to have a lot of restoration type of cleanup work in this video series on YouTube. I'm going to put all of that on my Instagram page. So if you want to see how I go about cleaning up things like this, go to Instagram and you can follow along there for that detail. I'm going to go ahead and remove the starter next. 2 8 millimeter bolts here. They're pretty tight. Try to use a 6-point socket if you can. Mm.
just an O-ring holding that in, but it's stubborn. There we go. That's all I was working against, was the friction of that O-ring.
Combination of 8mm bolts and 12. I think just these two 12s. And again, these are pretty tight. So I'm using a 6-point socket. I know I keep beating that drum, but I think it's important.
Okay, so I'm gonna pry on it, but I wanna talk a little bit about how I choose a pry point. You know, you don't wanna go digging in here, and that's just not enough of a lip, but look at this spot right here. There, I'm not gonna do much damage to anything, and I'll have good leverage. I just probably use a different screwdriver, maybe a Phillips or something that'll get further down in that hole, and I'll pry against that. You don't want to crack any aluminum pieces, so I'm, you know, this is a feel thing. Don't go crazy. This can end really badly if you move too quickly or get in a hurry. Okay, I found another good spot up in here where I can get a nice flat surface, and I've already started to drive some water out of there, so I'm making progress. There's a lot of water coming out, so clearly I am separating the pieces some. Okay, I'm getting a fair amount of liquid out of here because I'm making progress on it. So I'm just mopping that up a little bit with some shop towel. I think what I'm going to do is heat it. Not too much, because I know there's a rubber O-ring in there.
Like motorcycles, custom builds, or just like a good story about a man's 3-year effort to build a tribute to his childhood teacher, get a copy of Creating Mr. Corton. In it, you'll learn how this man changed this man for the better, how this man took this and built this, how these guys became lifelong friends and enthusiasts of motorcycling and craftsmanship, and how the name Urban Monk originated. It's available from Amazon anywhere in the world that Amazon ships, in both paperback and ebook, or you can purchase through a link found on urbanmonktv.com. Get your copy of Creating Mr. Corton today.
Coming.
There we go.
The other thing that's on here is or in here I should say, is there's dowels here and here that make coming on and off straight important. Right around this dowel is where I'm hung up the most right now. There we go. All right. No, it was not so much glued on as it is just corrosion around that dowel, both of them. So, next step, take off this cap nut and the copper washer and the impeller. This is 10 millimeter. It's not on very tight. And then just careful not to lose the copper washer. And I should be able to remove the impeller now. Okay. So just gently wiggling back and forth as I pull it outward. And we're talking gingerly there. Don't go wrecking that surface. There's that mechanical seal. That guy. Oddly, the service manual does not say to remove the gear shift lever at some point, but clearly we're going to have an interference there if I don't, so I'm going to pull that off right now. Spread and pry, how about that? There we go. Good times. Clean up. Okay. Lots of 8mm and 12mm bolts all around. 8, 8, 8, and a couple of 8s down here. Sorry. And then I see one 8mm bolt down here. Let me show you. Coming down from the wiring harness is this electrical cable and this guide, and there's an 8mm just holding that guide there. From what I can see, that is going to have to, well, maybe the whole thing comes with. We'll see. Okay, I took all of the bolts out, and I'm happy to report that all the 12 millimeter head bolts are the same length, and so are all the 8mm head bolts. So, you know, you really can't get these screwed up. That's nice. Suzuki had different lengths and sizes all over the place on the GS550. What a nice convenience. Anyways, let me get these cleaned up off camera. I loosened them off camera because you can imagine how boring that is to watch. Almost as boring as this scene I'm shooting right now. I was looking at this a while and discovered something so cool. This guy right here. When you put a 10 millimeter wrench on that and turn it counterclockwise, it begins to crack the case open for you with ease. Isn't that nice? It's just beautiful. Oh, and I'm getting engine oil. So yeah, of course, as soon as I open the case up, oil comes out. Gentle. There we go. I was just stuck on the shaft of the seal up here. I can see that that gear shift shaft wants to come out with it a little bit.
trying to make sure it doesn't for now. And we do have a magnet in the rotor around the stator here. Oh, that was my clutch gear. Sorry, starter clutch gear. That'll go back in later. No biggie. And we're off. Like hurry turtles. Okay. Good times. Funky smell. There's our stator that we need to repair. So I'm cleaning up the oil and want to share a little something. So I come across this little
washer. And I think to myself, where does that go? Well, what piece fell out when I was taking the rear cover off? This is probably a no-brainer, but you know, that's the first question I ask myself is, what went oddly about the procedure I just did? And maybe these two are connected. This goes on that starter gear, and I'll show you.
Actually, I found two of them. Another one was lying there, and you know, it happens to fit this little wear mark on this gear on both sides. Just a perfect fit. So my intuition tells me that it goes on here. Let me think that, yeah, that goes that way. And there. But let me check the parts diagram to be sure.
Yes, that is correct, and this is the right orientation because that engages the starter.
So the starter comes through here, engages those teeth, and then on the other side you have this gear,
which engages this gear here, and this is a clutch. So you see how this will spin one way, but I can't spin it the other. It only goes one direction. When the engine's running, it free spins. When you engage the starter, it engages the crankshaft. The other thing I will note here is this goo behind this oil seal, this is coolant leaking through from the water pump, mixing with oil, and dripping down into our engine, and it's actually collecting, sorry, it's collecting at the bottom of the crankcase. You know, it's a good thing that I'm taking this apart when I am.
So I'm thinking that's a wrap. This will be the engine rear cover removal video, and it seems like a logical place to stop, because from here we want to repair that stator, and I'm still making up my mind how I want to go about doing that. Stay tuned to this channel to see what I decide to do. Hey, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you want to become an urban monk and have all this fun in your garage like me. And check out my book on urbanmonktv.com. You can get this memoir called Creating Mr. Corton that I wrote. It is a memoir about the building of a GS550 cafe racer. It's a memoir of buying a CX500 as a teen in the mid-80s in Fargo, North Dakota. And it is a tribute to my middle shop, metal shop teacher who got me started on this path and brought all this fun into my life at an early age. Thanks for watching.